This is 13 Heathen speaking. I was recently asked a question via personal message, actually it was a week or two ago by now, by somebody who has their YouTube account set up so that you can only respond to them if you're on some list of theirs or some friends or some nonsense like this. So needless to say, I did not email a response, so I figured I'd get around to making a video eventually. And now that I think of it, I think it might have been a little bit longer ago than that, now that I stop and think about it, because it was before I headed up to Free OK, which incidentally was fun. I got to meet the speakers up there, and it was pretty cool. I got to meet the thinking atheists and some of the other folks up there, and that was really fun. Anyway, I'm supposed to be answering a question here. The question was having to do with presuppositional apologetics. I've made a couple videos on this discussing basically what's wrong with the argument. For example, the fact that if you can't have a presuppositional discussion unless both people accept the presupposition. If otherwise, you're just talking past each other. This is nonsense. I mean, I had somebody coming into my channel a while back on one of these videos, that one in specific, I believe, in which they're challenging me to a debate on the topic of whether or not I believe in God. This is stupid. You want to debate upon... You want to have a debate based upon whether or not somebody else believes something? Huh? Anyway, the question that I was recently asked was, how would I respond, technically, how would one respond, to Sye Ten or Eric Hovind? My answer for Sye is a little bit different than for the standard apologist that attempts to use this ploy. And I suppose I will get to that. But dealing with your standard apologist with this, I would simply turn to them and say, oh, so you're an atheist. And they'd, no, I'm a Christian, or what have you. They'd give whatever answer they want to. And no, you're an atheist. You're promoting an atheist's argument here. Come on, I mean, you've listened to that presentation. Have you ever said this to somebody and actually have them cry like Sye says that the people do when they're told that they believe in God? Come on, you know better. This guy's an atheist that's just promoting this horrendously bad argument to try and promote atheism indirectly. He's trying to tear down the walls from the inside. Haven't you figured that out yet? And I know that you're only promoting this argument because you know that there is no God. It's clear, I can see it in you. You know, you've gone there, you've gone through all the other arguments, you know that they're not working and that they don't do anything, in some cases you probably know they don't make sense, and you're resorting to this because you have this emotional investment that you're trying to hold on to that last little shred of faith with everything you have. It's kind of cute. It's really kind of cute when you think about it, but I mean, you know that there's no God, and you know that you're an atheist deep down inside. You're a non-believer. Yeah, you're just, come on, you're just putting on an act. You know it. What? This is my presupposition. You have your presupposition, I have mine. Maybe that would illustrate to them why the argument has no teeth. I'd use a similar approach while dealing with Sye, and I'd probably, if you were to try and say something, I'd say, ah, so you're are you Sye Ten? No. Rhymes with Satan, doesn't it? Never mind. But I'd probably praise him, if I were dealing with Sye directly, I'd praise him for doing such a good job at knocking down the walls of religion and promoting atheism and showing how ridiculous and feeble the religious arguments really are. I mean, yes, you can't prove a negative, so you can't prove that there's no God, but certainly Sye shows how pathetic and ridiculous these notions are through such a idiotic argument, that this is the last bastion of, this is the last little niche that theism has to hold in to try and validate their nonsense, and tell them that it's a great way, really, for these people that technically know that there's no God, to try and promote their agenda. But then I'd have to scold him about the immorality of milking the believers in the process. You know, the ends and the means and all that. Promoting atheism through milking the Christians out of their money and promoting such a horrible argument, basically to shut down atheists instead of actually challenging their views. That's roughly the approach I'd take, dealing with Sye as opposed to the regular theist. Because really, they're not going to accept your presupposition any more than you're going to accept theirs. But if their goal is to shut you down, I think maybe the best thing is to try and shut them down. And if you really go with the whole, yeah, you're a non-believer, and you know it deep down inside, they might stop and later down the road wonder if there might be some truth in what you're saying. It could potentially lead to somebody sitting back and saying, you know, do I? Now, this is part of the idea behind the whole you know, that they're trying to do in terms of the atheists, is to try and make them sit back and think, well, you know, maybe. No. Sorry. Now, I'm different from most people in one regard, in that I used my daughter as a guinea pig when she was very small. I kept her away from references to God. And there was never any real inference there that this whole claim, which is throughout all the holy texts, people just, when they're born, they know. She didn't. It wasn't until her aunt started talking to her about angels and whatnot that this word, this concept, magically entered her vernacular. Her vocabulary, whatever. But the concept didn't really come up until somebody introduced it to her. This isn't something that's natural. This isn't something that you're born with. She's disproof of that. The same held true of my son until he started being introduced to these wacky concepts as well. Muslims, for that matter, will claim that everyone knows Allah. They refer to people that return to the faith as... People that convert to Islam, they refer to as reverts, claiming that they knew this and they were taught something else, and then they're coming back to the faith because they were born knowing. It's been disproved. Every person that is raised without a theology that ends up not believing, that doesn't accept it, that can't take that funny pill of faith, because they look at it, and they weren't raised with this nonsense, and they look at it and go, really, talking donkeys? The Bible? Really? Is this Shrek? Are we talking like donkey, like Shrek and donkey, when that donkey's sitting there saying, you know, I see an angel in front of you and this and that, should we be hearing Eddie Murphy's voice talking? Come on! Really? Yeah, it probably would be funny. It doesn't work. And to claim everyone knows this, and using these as being your scientific tests, these children that weren't raised with these beliefs and that don't magically have them, lo and behold, in my journey to, well, I should say my journey away from any concept of a theistic view of reality, this was my test. This was the test that I said, okay, fine, if this is what is being claimed, that people are supposed to know this, because this is a big deal, it's supposed to be, you know, written on your heart and all this kind of nonsense. Let's test it scientifically. And the way that I raised my daughter was indeed a scientific test, thank you very much, and God failed the test, this God notion. Sorry. So you can presuppose all you want, because you're just talking past someone. It's pointless. It's useless. And frankly, based upon his presentation, I really do think that Sye is a non-believer that's simply trying to make a buck from the believers. Now, is that some kind of proof that he's really faking it and all this other stuff? No, it's not proof. However, if he has his presupposition, I can run with mine, too. 13 Heathen signing out. Have a good day.